Let me offer my congratulations and prayers to Professor Philip, who is completing 60 years of his teaching career, starting from his days at the XLRI to the present moment as the chairman of Zaim Bangalore.
On August 15, 1947, India woke up to a new dawn. The first Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru, raised the Indian national flag above the Lahore Gate of Red Fort in Delhi. Definitely a thrilling moment for India. At the same time, in a very green and unspoiled corner of rural Kerala in South India, 11-year-old boy named Joe Philip gave a speech on freedom, and people couldn't appreciate him enough for his eloquence, boldness and clarity of thought. During his teens, Joe Philip was active in Seva Dal, the grassroots front organization of Indian National Congress. While leadership skills came naturally to him, he learned many lessons there that significantly helped him later in life. Surrounded by the lush green of spring, tucked away in the serene calmness of nature, there are a lot more amazing things about Pulingunnu, a village in Alappuzha district which devoured the boat race as its favourite sport. Born on 21st May 1936 as a son of Pulingunnu Kapil Varki Joseph and Mariamma of Changanasheri Olasa family, Joe Philip had seven siblings, five brothers and two sisters. He had his primary level education at Mary Mata School and secondary level at St. Joseph's High School, Pulingunnu. Graduated from the SB College, Changanasheri in 1955, Professor J. Philip did his law degree at Maharaja's Law College, Kochi. After a brief stint in law, coming through Bar Council exam with flying colours, Professor J. Philip changed his career and focus of interest as he joined the HR program of the prestigious XLRI Jamshedpur. Professor J. Philip completed his master's program in personal management and industrial relations from XLRI in 1960. As a young man, Joe Philip was open to new ideas, possibilities and perspectives. He believed that education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. On June 3, 1963, Joe Philip married Leelamma, the daughter of Philip Kondodi Vagathanam and Anna Vachaparambal. Leelamma was serving as a teacher at the St. Teresa School, Ernakulam that time.
He started sighing after our daughter Maria's death because she had a dream. She told her father, "Daddy, why don't you start your own institute instead of struggling? I will come and help you." After her death, it was his idea and his vision to fulfill her dream. Because it was Maria's dream, I am fully for that. I can say that from the beginning, I found him as a workaholic, and education was his ambition. So he started Zaim and made it.
Joining XLRI Jamshedpur as a faculty member, he quickly rose in ranks in recognition to become a professor and dean in 1970, that too at an age of 34. Professor J. Philip was one of the founders of XLRI's prestigious PGDM program. His key achievements during this period include the areas of curriculum development, program administration, faculty and students management, and industry interaction program administration, faculty and students management and industry interaction. He also started the MDP division of XLRI. It is at XLRI that Professor J. Philip acquired much of his extensive experience in institution building and networking, along with a deep commitment and love for business education. While at XLRI in September 1965, he was selected for the International Teachers Program in Business Administration of Harvard Business School. Philip particularly recalls four courses of great value for him at HBS, OB, Case Writing and Case Teaching, University Administration and Business Policy. Being with the XLRI for more than 11 years, Professor J. Philip left his mother-like institution to join a public sector undertaking, SAIL, aiming at gaining industrial experience to solicit feedback from customers, vendors, and production staff. Industrial experience entails discipline. It ensures importance of punctuality and the sense of urgency too. His thought process got formulated by observing businesses in action, and his ideas thus formulated altered many businesses later. As the principal of Sales Management Training Institute, he built it to a high level of excellence during his 8-year and 3-month tenure. Professor J. Philip had the opportunity to attend large number of management development programs, international conferences, and leadership programs. While at Sale, he founded the journal Growth and developed a number of case studies. In 1980, Professor J. Philip left Sale and joined Oberoi Group as Vice President Human Resources. He served as a systemizing, policing arm and reworked the entire HR system of the company. His significant contributions include a career planning system, new appraisal system, and a dynamic compensation system. With this private sector exposure at a vantage point, having rounded off his experience, Professor Philip returned to academics in 1985 as the director of IIM Bangalore. These 6 years were a period of considerable growth for the institute, marked by a series of innovations and pace-setting activities. Academically and professionally, the institute reached a high level of performance and accomplishment with Professor Philip at the helm. For the pure academics, any discussion of the real world is anathema. But Professor Philip was not to be bound by such notions, particularly in the business management world. He launched the International Teachers Program in Management and enabled IIMB to become a participating institution in the Indo-EC project for faculty exchanges and cooperation, comprising 7 management schools of Europe. Aptly called the turnaround director of IIMB at a critical time when the institute was facing a multitude of problems, especially employee union related, and as its head, Professor Philip was able to transform it into one of the top management institutions of the country. Professor J. Philip's eldest daughter, Maria, was a master's student in personal management. The exceptionally brilliant and idealistic girl died in a train accident in 1986. Everyone in Professor J. Philip's family had loved Maria to bits and were completely devastated by the tragedy. As a fulfillment of his late daughter Maria Teresa Philip's dream, Professor Philip, along with a few other acclaimed academicians and practitioners, founded Zyme in June 1991 at Bangalore. The evolution of Zyme since then into a premier business school of the country is a measure of his institution-building caliber. Zyme has been able to attract many high-rated international professors to teach in India. From its humble beginning in Bangalore, Zyme has risen to a world-class institution with fully residential campuses in Bangalore, Kochi, and Chennai. Professor J. Philip is also one of them who had dreamt of excellence, innovations, and path-breaking reforms in management education field. Professor J. Philip's life is not confined to his designation as chairman of Xavier Institute of Management and Entrepreneurship. As a homegrown guru in management education, he made choices regarding which to focus on and nurture in students in order to produce impactful, practical managers. In Professor Philip, one can see a dynamic, decisive and development-oriented educationist who has emerged as a ray of hope for the dreams and aspirations of the management students. His life has been a journey of courage, determination and continuous hard work. A debate competition is organized under the initiative of Professor Philip every year to commemorate the memory of Maria, who was an excellent debater, and to encourage debating talent among college students. Zyme has been organizing this contest for over 23 years now. Besides XLRI and IIMB, Professor J. Philip has been instrumental in founding or nurturing several prominent institutions and organizations such as RMA, Ranchi Management Association, Ranchi Cheshire Home, AIMS, Association of Indian Management Schools, and ABS, Association of BRICS Business Schools. He was also a founding trustee of the Bangalore International Center. Professor Philip is definitely a warm-hearted and friendly individual who contributed enormously to the development of management education in the country in general and to Zyme in particular. Along with his contributions to teaching, training and HRD, Professor Philip has authored a number of books and also presented papers at various national and international fora, many of which have been published in leading journals and magazines. A few of them are Multiple Stakeholder Perspectives of Higher and Engineering Education, the chapter titled Leadership and Excellence in Higher Education, Macmillan India Business Education in India, A Ringside View, Global Management Education, Country Studies, Institution Building in India, Some Experiences. As co-editor of Management Education in India, co-author of Management the Simple Way, being a helping hand in their educational journey and traveling with them with true inspiration, the parental encouragement played an ample role in his children's successful career. His second daughter, Dr. Sheba, is a medical practitioner in Atlanta, USA.
For the future, I still see him not slowing down, although he should at this age, but he's an inspiration to so many people. His drive cannot compete with anybody else's, and he inspires people just because of his drive to do things. Dad, I love you very much. You've been a great influence to me. I look up to you in so many different ways. You've always been there for me, and I love you dearly, and I appreciate you for everything you've done for me.
Anil, the youngest of the three, is an engineer cum MBA who holds the position of senior vice president at Vodafone Idea in Mumbai.
Daddy, where you really stood apart was in how you always thought well ahead of your times, probably 10 years ahead. And once that idea was generated, it was as if you put it on a bullet train to execute. A few examples come to mind. Can management schools collaborate to share best practices instead of competing for rankings? Is what prompted you to start the Association of Indian Management Schools in 1988. When most people looked at BRICS only as fast-growing economies, you saw an opportunity for these schools to come together to share, and you founded as its president in 1999. Organizations over the last 10 years have been pushing the diversity agenda. Zion in 1995 had 40% women diversity. At 84 years and 60 years of work under your belt, I see the energy level of a young man. Bringing excellence to management education was your calling. I dedicate this quote of Jesse Owens to you and your life. We all have dreams, but in order to make dreams come to reality, it takes an awful lot of determination, dedication, and self-discipline. Here is toasting to the next 10 years.
Professor Phillips' family is settled in Koramangala, Bangalore. Honored for demonstrating outstanding achievement in an understanding of management education implementation, as well as his passion for teaching and his examples of successful lessons.
Professor Philip is a man of character. He respects others in different strata of the society and ensures the support and encouragement of the authorities or the government and of the society for all his activities. He is a man of a deep faith in God, and he believes that it is God's grace that is behind his success in life. I have only great admiration and appreciation of the lifetime achievement of Professor Philip.
Speaking about Jose Philip, his success was due to his dedication and sincerity. Wherever he worked, there was no question of compromising with anything else except for the improvement of the institution which he established. That is why, one after the other, successively at least three institutes of a similar nature. I have only to wish Godspeed to him, because he must have a longer life for serving this country in the field of management institutes. I pray to God to give him long life, healthy life, and also bless him to produce similar institutions and serve this nation well.
Professor Philip received the Lifetime Achievement Award for Excellence in the Profession and Societal Contribution by XLRI, instituted by the Alumni Association of XLRI.
I am extremely happy to know that Professor Philip is celebrating Diamond Jubilee of his professional career on 3rd of July 2020. He is one of the rarest of rare indeed. In my view, his masterstroke was the formation of Siam Society and establishing three top-class business schools in the country. Dear Professor Philip, you are one of the greatest friends of the Archdiocese of Trichur. I record with deep gratitude for your contribution in the field of management and in training to the Archdiocese of Trichur. Dear Professor, you have completed only 6 decades of your career. As I know you well, you have still to go for a few more. On this occasion, my colleagues and I from the Archdiocese of Trichur extend our warmest greetings and prayers for achieving the milestone of Diamond Jubilee.
First of all, I want to thank God for the gift of Professor Philip to humanity and to management education in general. A great visionary, you are able to convert your dreams into reality. With a group of 8 religious and lay people, you managed to implement your shared vision into reality. That reality is XIME Bangalore in 1991. In my professional and personal life, Professor Philip was truly a friend, philosopher and guide. I say that in the literal sense of the word. You harness the power of teamwork, global network, strategic linkages with institutions in India and abroad. You have succeeded in getting XIME, one of the top business schools in the country. I salute you, Professor Philip, a great management guru and thinker, outstanding leader and visionary, as you are being felicitated for completing your fixed 60 years in professional life. May God continue to give you good health to carry on the good work for many, many more years to come.
We all grew up in the 1960s and 70s when there was the rock music group called Beatles. When they reached 64 years of age, they sang, "Do you still love me when I am 64? Do you still need me when I am 64? Today, perhaps Professor Philip may be thinking in his mind, do we need him when he is 84? We can assure him, today in the disruptive atmosphere, somebody like him with all the leadership experience, with all the experience of having reached excellence, he will be most needed. I am sure under his leadership, XIME will continue to grow and conquer new horizons in the years to come. All the best."
And he has remained as an ideal teacher. To my mind, an ideal teacher is one who loves his subject, who is proud of his profession of teaching, and who loves his students. I have seen that Professor Philip fulfills all these 3 attributes of an ideal teacher. I respect him, I admire him for his qualities of head and heart as a teacher and as a good human being who sticks to the principles and values he cherishes. On behalf of all the students who have benefited from this great teacher, I wish Professor Philip all that is best in life.
List of awards and accolades received by Professor J. Philip: Fellow of Association of Indian Management Schools, AIIMS, XLRI Life Achievement Award, 21st November 2009, AIIMA Keval Noria Award for Leadership in Management Education, September 2011, the Mauritius Le Matinal Innovative Educational Leadership Award, December 2011. Dr. Suresh Ghai Memorial Award for Outstanding Management Education Leadership at the Higher Education Forum's HEF Teachers' Day event on Saturday, 3rd September 2016. Guardians of Knowledge, an initiative from the Hindu group to recognize and highlight the exemplary educationists in Karnataka. Excellent Chairman of Leading Institute of India, CSR Awards Night 2018 on April 22, 2018. CSR Award Night on Sunday, April 21st, 2019 at Hotel Le Meridien, New Delhi. Lifetime Excellence Award of Archdiocese of Changanasheri given on 20th May 2019 in Trivandrum. Business Excellence Award was presented to him by Business Deepika in Delhi in March 2020.
Professor Philip is celebrating his 60 years of teaching career. His professional career coincides with the evolution of Indian management education, with his involvement in XLRI and IIM Bangalore at its early stages. He always kept in touch with the changes taking place in management education worldwide. Out of his 60 years of professional service, last 30 years is with SIBE as its founder and builder. I had the privilege of involving with SIBE right from its inception and had witnessed the dedication and hard work with which Professor Philip has built SIBE. Capability to deliver is the factor which determines the age of retirement. On that yardstick, SIBE can expect the guidance of Professor Philip for many more years to come. Let the Almighty give that privilege to SIBE.
It is given only to a few to have served in an academic or professional domain for a period as long as 60 years. But longevity is only one aspect. To have served with distinction, to have left behind a tricord of achievements all around, that belongs to the rarest of rare cases category. Professor Philip belongs to this category. He has been an outstanding teacher, a high-performing dean in an illustrious Indian business school, a model achiever in the public sector, an executive of great tone and caliber in the hotel sector of in the private sector.
Professor Joe Philip, the man of the moment. Professor Philip is blessed with a pleasing, inspiring, and attracting smile like a magnet. I have been associating with Professor Philip and SIBE Society for the last 26 years as a member and a vice president for several years. Ever since I met Professor Philip in Dubai in 1994. During my association with Professor Philip, I observed some distinct qualities and achievements which make him a true role model for the younger generation of the day. Professor Philip is known to be an institution builder. My family and I extend our warm greetings to Professor Philip and family and pray that Almighty continues to bless Professor Philip with good health and peace to carry on for several more years to fulfill his unfulfilled dreams. Thank you.
It has been a great privilege to know and to have served under an academician of the stature of Professor Joe Philip. 30 years ago, after retiring as the director of India's most famous business school, and preceding that, a storied career in management education and working in top positions in some of India's most famous companies, he founded the Zime Group of Institutions. As he completes 60 years of his professional life, he can look back on an eventful and successful career imbued with social purpose. But knowing Professor Philip, that is the last thing he will do. In his usual way, he will be looking to the future about how to make his beloved Zime more relevant in a rapidly changing business environment, imparting in his students cutting-edge knowledge to make them the business and social leaders of tomorrow.
And looking back at my 60 years, I'd like to start by thanking God for giving me the 60 years and taking me up to this 84 years. It's a very satisfying run. It's a long, long run. But looking back, it's a very, very satisfying run. Stephen Covey, the famous writer, author of this book, Seven Habits of Highly Effective People, have asked one question. Start with the end in mind. So I asked this question. Okay, my end is not too far away. So how did I leave? If I were to start all over again, Now, I think I had done certain things for the good of the country, for the good of the youth of India, for the good of the cause of education. The most exciting thing that happened to me was the founding of Excitement. That was the most satisfying thing. Very dear to my heart. It was very dear to my heart because it was the advice, plea of my late daughter, Maria. She was the one who asked me a week before she died that I must found a business school after my term with IIM Bangalore. So every time I see the 180 students streaming out of this place at the convocation, I'm reminded of her. It was her advice. We started in a small way. 10,000 rupees was the original capital. And we started an asbestos shed institution. Today we have 3 campuses, sprawling campuses, beautiful campuses. Madras particularly is very, very beautiful. And we have 180 students in this campus, 420 in all, which will reach 500 this year, at the beginning of this year. Our admissions will be 500, which is not a small number. And about 4,000 alumni, very well placed at very high positions. There are a number of unique things about this place. One is 55 to 60% of the students admitted are girls. I think that is the highest in any good business school in India. A second one is we announce and we live by. That is the soul of this place. That's a student-centric place. I always say, this place is for students, not for me, not for anybody else. And third one, we said, if we don't transform the students as managers, we use the expression transformation, leadership. So two things which happen here all the time, that we transform them, both in values and competence. So therefore, there is heavy emphasis on pedagogy, which is experience-based, experiential, we call it, not just lectures. One unique skill, special skill that we give here is in communication. Our students come out as very good communicators. No wonder they win in large number of competitions in the country. When I was building this place, a model that I had in my mind was XLRI. That was where I cut my teeth as a professional. Way back in 1960, July 3. And I learned a few things there. One, the whole organization, institution was committed to student development. That's it. Development was the word. Development of the spirit and development of the soul. And there was a climate and atmosphere for the student development. Third one was huge number of activities. The same thing we want to repeat here. You develop leadership or you transform students by giving them opportunities to lead. That is one of the things that we do here. Thinking of XLRI, one of my happiest things, as I talk about XIME, is the founding of the MBA program of XLRI in 1968. When I missed a point while I was recounting my experience, and that was about building associations, professional associations, one of my contributions to the profession. When I came to IIM Bangalore, I realized Indian business schools did not have a platform, a forum of their own. I said, "Ekya baat hai? It cannot happen. Every country, America has it, Canada has it, Europe has it, ASEAN has it." So we must have one. So I took the initiative and founded in 1988 the Association of Indian Management Schools. And I was its president for the first 4 years, making sure it's established. So that was one contribution about which I'm very proud. But then that reminds me, the previous year, I was in Kathmandu along with a few of our friends from the SAARC region in founding another association called AMDISA, for the SAARC region. That was for the region. And later in 2009, we here at XIME founded ABBS. ABBS standing for Association of BRICS Business Schools, with representatives from China, Russia, Brazil, South Africa and India participating. And I was also the founder president of that. Coming home, I thought we should have an association for Karnataka. Business schools of Karnataka must have an association. And so pulled together the colleagues from the autonomous institutions. We got together leading autonomous business schools of Karnataka and formed the Karnataka Association of Autonomous Business Schools. Putting it together, it comes to me like this: statewide basis, national basis, region SAARC, and the BRICS region. Did I deliberately do it? No, it just happened. I mean, it's God has His own ways. He made me to do that. I'm very happy about that professional contribution. The other end, there is another thing I had done, some very surprising. When I was in Ranchi, there is a Cheshire home there, which was in total decay, in an almost failed situation. Some of my friends asked me to take it over, Cheshire home, with some colleagues from the sale group. We took it over and made it one of the finest Cheshire homes of the country. It's again exciting, starting from scratch, from ground zero. We did not have an MBA program. 68, after my return from Harvard, one Father Collins and I together founded that, which has made XLRI famous and number one in the private sector. I'm so happy I could spend 11 years there, my formative years. Again, as part of looking back, I go back briefly to my IIM years. Again, a God-given opportunity to work in one of the topmost, or perhaps the top IIM, IIM Bangalore. I was there nearly 6 years. But unfortunately, when I went there, it was going through a bad patch, really bad patch. Union relations, employee morale, academic atmosphere, all these were at a low ebb. It was my task to bring it back that institutional excellence. And I did that. But of course, a vigorous struggle. The first 4 years was a vigorous struggle. And I did that. I said, look, I come here to do a job. And I'll do it. Otherwise, I'll quit. And I'm so happy that some of my colleagues called me as the turnaround director of IIM Bangalore. Again, these 60 years, I think I was somewhat different as a teacher, because I went to industry. From XLRI, I deliberately went to industry. Sale for 8 years, and Oberoi, private sector, for over 5 years. That 16 years, that 13 years, gave me a real understanding of management. I would like to tell any young faculty member, spend at least 2 years in industry. You cannot teach management without practicing it. That was a very deliberate and wise decision, which I think helped me in my career. Now, looking back again to the 60 years, which are my sunset years, I ask myself, what was I after? Maslow comes to my rescue. Abraham Maslow, in his need hierarchy, says the highest need, the higher level need, is self-actualization. That was what I was after. And I think I self-actualized. I did what I wanted to do. The real self-actualization was building XIME. And I thank my daughter Maria for that. And thank God for that. I want to thank some of the esteemed colleagues who worked with me in building XIME. I'll start with Professor J.D. Chiraya, former professor of Indian Institute of Science, a great scientist and a great thinker, wise man. He was almost my soulmate in building XIME.
I also remember Archbishop Alphonse Mathias, the first president, who helped us, supported us, kept us going in the difficult periods when we started 10,000 rupees. The 10,000 rupees took us now to 150 crores of investment, but without ever taking any money from any student or his or her father. And then, of course, another set of very senior colleagues, Mr. Sarosh Gandhi, Professor G.D. Kulkarni, Professor Krishnan, the first dean, Ambassador Ravindranathan, and my colleagues in the society, Dr. Alexander, Mr. P.C. Siriak, Mr. V.O. Sebastian, and lastly, but not the least, as the cliche goes, Mr. C.J. Kunjaraya, the secretary for now almost 14 or 15 years. Great man, to all of them, I owe so much. It's a joint effort, and I want to thank you and all others who contributed in building Zaim into what it is today. Now coming to Zaim, that's my love, that's my life. Over this time, when I come to these 60 years, the ardent, intent, deep prayers of my mother, I never thought I could make this run of 60 years. It has been a very, very satisfying run. Thank you, Lord, for everything that you've done for me. Thank you.
I'm happy to let you know that Zaim envisions discovering and deepening the understanding of management concepts and applications that drive effective organizations and use them to produce principled and insightful managers and entrepreneurs who create positive changes in the society and in a way in the larger world itself. Excellence is the watchword here at Zaim. He signs off with those words. Yes, the words of a dynamic entrepreneur full of charisma on the most sacred mission of educating the society. As management author Tom Peters so eloquently put it, leaders don't create followers, they create more leaders. Professor Philip learned to blend his roles as manager and leader and understood the importance of both tasks. Managers promote stability while leaders press for change. Zaim embraces both sides of the equation and moves ahead during this period of turbulence.